of a monkey in Persian robes, framed symbols. This item, discovered in your vaults at the theater, still in working order, ladies and gentlemen.
Showing here.
Thank you. Shalimo's animal.
Ladies and gentlemen, some of you may
already perhaps have met Monsieur André and Monsieur Fiona.
I'm sorry, Monsieur Lafayette, we are rehearsing. If you wouldn't mind waiting a moment.
My apologies, Monsieur Rayet. Proceed. Proceed.
Thank you, Monsieur.
Monsieur Rayet, our chief repentant. I'm a tyrant, I'm afraid.
From sad to return, Signor.
Sad to return to find I'm the widow. Fret in the summer, barren for a genius. Tomorrow is shall the chains of Roma. A night for a chance, your only hands come home.
Senor Piatti, our principal tenor, he doesn't play so well opposite to our Carlotta.
With a private rendition, unless, of course, Monsieur Rayet objects.
My manager commands it.
Mighty heart commands. Will 2 bars be sufficient introduction?
2 bars will be quite sufficient. Signora.
Beginning of the aria, then, mademoiselle. field.
So distant day, when you are far away and free, if you ever find a moment, spare a thought for me.
Thank you.
Madame Giry, are you a dancer? Then come and practice. My dear, I was asked to give you this.
Scarf.
Is here?
You can't have lost it. Not after all the trouble I took. I was just 14. Soaked to the skin.
Because you had run into the sea to fetch my scarf. Oh, Raoul, so it is you.
Christine. Little Artie, let her mind wander.
You remember that too?
Little Lottie thought, am I fonder of dolls, or of garlands,
of shoes, or of riddles, of frocks?
He knits in the attic. Of chocolates.
Father playing the violin.
As we read to each other dark stories of the North.
What I love best, Lottie said, is when I'm asleep in my bed, and the angel of
Come to me, angel.
is that in there?
I am your angel of music.
Thank you.
last heard you sing, I have needed you with pain to serve me, to sing for my
the power of the music. hell, but secretly yearns for heaven. Secretly, secretly, but Christy. Fear can turn to love. You'll learn to see, to find the man behind the monster. This repulsive carcass seems a beast, but secretly dreams of beauty. Secretly, secretly.
Still, at least the seats get sold. Gossip's worth its weight in gold. Diva tender's resignation. Covered as a moonlight flit. Half your cast disappears, but the crowd still cheers. Opera, to hell with book and handle. Have a scandal, and you're sure to have a Hannibal when they all walk out. This is damnable. Andre, please don't shout. It's publicity. Entertain is fast. Free publicity.
But we have no cast.
Right, Andre, have you seen the cue? Oh, it seems you've got one, too.
Dear Andre, what a charming gala. Christine enjoyed a great success. We were hardly bereft when Carlotta left. Otherwise, the chorus was entrancing, but the dancing was a lamentable mess.
Dear Vivette, just a quick reminder. My salary has not been paid. Send in care of a ghost by return of post. PTO. No one likes a debtor, so it's better if my orders are obeyed.
Who would have the gall to send this? Someone with a puerile brain.
These are both psychogenes.
Who the hell is he?
A ghost. It's really not amusing.
He's abusing our position.
In addition, he wants money.
He's a funny sort of spectre. To expect a large retainer, nothing plainer. He is clearly quite
fishy.
You'll be part of
a dream, Mr. Where is she?
Perhaps you'll be
no answer. I take it that you sent me this note.
It's all this nonsense. Of course not. Don't look at us.
She's not with you then.
Of course not.
We're in the dark, so don't argue. Isn't this the letter you wrote?
And what is it that we're meant to have wrote? Written.
Do not fear for Miss Taye. The angel of music has her under his wing. Make no attempt to see her again.
If you didn't write it, who did?
Where is he?
The man, your precious patron.
Where is he?
What is it now?
A letter which I rather resent.
And did you send it?
Of course not.
As if he would.
You didn't send it.
Of course not.
What's going on? You didn't tell me that this is not the letter you sent.
And what is it that I meant to have sent? Your days at the opera populaire are numbered. Christine Dye will be singing on your behalf tonight. Be prepared for a great misfortune should you attempt to take her place.
Far too many notes for my taste, and most of them about Christine. All we've heard since we came is Miss Dye's thing.
Miss Dye has returned.
In which case, I think our meeting is adjourned.
Where precisely is she now?
I thought it best that she went home. She needed rest.
May I see her?
No, monsieur, she will see no one.
Will she see?
I have a note.
Let me see it, please.
Gentlemen,
I have now sent you several notes of the most amiable nature, detailing how my theater is to be run. You have not followed my instructions. I shall give you one last chance. Christine Dye has returned to you, and I am anxious her career should progress. In the new production of Il Muto, you will therefore cast Carlotta as the page and put Miss Dye in the role of Countess. The role which Miss Dye plays calls for charm and appeal. The role of the page boy is silent, which makes my casting, in a word, ideal. I shall watch the performance from my normal seat in box 5. Which will be kept empty for me. Should these commands be ignored,
a disaster beyond your imagination will occur. I remain, gentlemen, your obedient servant, O.G.
Christine!
Can you believe this?
The silent role.
Carlotta will be playing the lead.
You're not the charmer. It's a useless crying to
you bow out when they're shouting your name.
Him.
Christine.
Your part. Be silent. Little toad.
A toad, madam? Perhaps it is you who are the toad.
Maestro, da capo, per favore. Serafino, away with this prince. You cannot speak, but kiss me and my husband.
The phantom is available. Believe me, there is no man.
waiting. Can I ever escape that face so distorted, deformed, it was hardly a face in that darkness?
Thank you.
promise me. You help me so this scene.
It's an engagement, not a crime. Christine, what are you?
Should be clear. Remember, there are worse things than a shattered chandelier.
Your chains are still mine. You will sing for me.
He had once built for the Shah of Persia
a maze of mirrors.
Who was this man?
A freak of nature, more monster than man.
What
a horror. Worth it.
Oh my God, Christine.
And then he went missing. He escaped.
Go on.
They never found him. It was said he had died.
He didn't die, did he?
The world forgot him, but I never can. For in this darkness
and
I
so
have
this
seen
phantom's
him.
Our man.
Wait.
Too much, monsieur. And there have been too many accidents.
Accidents? Madame Giry?
Ludicrous, have you seen us for?
Ludicrous.
It's the final straw.
This is lunacy. Have you no mind, you?
Utter lunacy.
I refuse.
Not another chandelier.
Look, my friend, what we have here.
Dear Henri, be my orchestrations. We need another first bassoon. The three notes overblown and the third trombone has to go. The man cannot be never so pleased, preferably one who plays in tune.
Dear, fear my vis-a-vis my opera. Some chorus members must be sacked. If you could find out which has a sense of pitch, why, Slippo, I've managed to assign a rather minor role to those who cannot act.
But an outrage! This whole affair is an outrage!
How what's the matter?
Have you seen this before?
Signora, listen.
It's an illness!
I thought you as well.
Just look at this! It's an illness!
I misunderstand.
Signora, signora!
Things I'm going to do for my heart!
If you can call this gibberish art!
You resemble the flower.
Ah, bestowed by the Lady of the Hour.
You have secured the largest throne in this Dunlop.
Christina, she doesn't have the voice.
Then I take it you all agree.
She's behind this.
It appears we have no choice.
She's the one behind this, Christine Dye.
How dare you?
I'm not a fool.
You evil woman, how dare you?
You think I'm blind?
This isn't my fault. I don't want any part in this
plot. It's not me, sure. It's your decision, but why not?
She's backing up.
You have a duty.
I cannot sing it, duty or not.
Christine, you don't have to. They can't make you.
Please, monsieur, another note. Fondest greetings to you all. A few instructions just before rehearsal starts. Carlotta
must be taught to act, not her normal trick of strutting round the stage. Our Don Juan must lose some weight. It's not healthy in a man of Pianchi's age. And my managers must learn that their place is in an office, not the arts. As for Miss Christine Dye, no doubt she'll do her best. It's true her voice is good. She knows though, should she wish to excel, she has much still to learn. If Bride will let her return to me, her teacher. Your obedient friend.
And angel. I can't. I won't do it.
I've all been blind. And yet the answer is staring us in the face. This could be the chance to ensnare our clever friend.
Listening to
play his name. Perform his work, but remember, we will be his. Forgive Miss Dicey.
He is certain to attend.
We make certain the doors are barred. We make certain our men are there.
We make certain our mark.
The curtain falls. His reign will end.
Madness!
I'm not so sure.
Not if it were.
This is madness!
The tide will turn.
Monsieur, but we need it. It's the way of turning the tide.
You stitch the ballet.
Help us.
Instead of warning us, help us!
I wish we could!
Don't make excuses! Or could it be that you're of his side?
She's a complete!
Thank you. Wildly my mind beats against you.
Resist, yet your soul
Can't you see she'll never be yours? Christine? Christine!
Val!
Bravo, monsieur! It's a spirit of her!
No tricks, monsieur!
And she must have fought you, terrible! That's right! Keep walking, Miss Boyd!
You cannot come up by making her your prisoner!
Stop, darling Christine!
Stay quiet!
I'm here, monsieur, the angel of death!
So I fear you not!
Come on! Come on, don't stop! Don't stop!
No.
Forget myself and love.
trap is set and waits for its prey. You have come here in pursuit of your deepest search, in pursuit of that wish which till now has been silent, silent. I have brought you that our passions may fuse and merge. In your mind, you've already succumbed to me, dropped all defenses, completely succumbed to me. Second thoughts, you've decided. Decided. Past the point of no return, no backward glances. Threshold, one more unspoken song.
Why, you ask, was I bound and chained in this cold and dismal place? Not for any mortal sin, but the wickedness of my abhorrent face! Everyone met with hatred everywhere. No kind word from anyone, no compassion anywhere. Christine, why?
Madame Giry! Thank you.
Monsieur, I bid you welcome.
forgive me.
Kris Koop.